Stray Kids! Happy Sunday, everyone! Thank you for joining our online service. Before we get started with our lesson, I have a few friends who would like to say hi. Come on, everyone!
Bonjour, everybody!
Jumbo!
Hola!
Ciao!
Whoa, whoa, whoa! I don't think any of that was in English. My friends just said hello in Swahili, Spanish, French, and Italian. That is so cool. That is four different languages right there. And did you know that that's not even a smidgen of the amount of languages that are spoken all over the world? There are over 6,500 languages spoken worldwide. That is crazy. But you know what's even crazier? Is that once upon a time, there was only one language spoken in all of the world. I know, that is so cool. And today in our Bible lesson, we are going to find out just how there became so many languages all over the world today. I am so, so excited. So let's get going.
Bienvenidos.
Konnichiwa.
Karate.
Allo, spricht du Deutsch?
Ni hao, xie xie.
Jag förstår inte så mycket svenska. I think I just said I don't know a lot of Swedish in Swedish. Have you ever wondered where all the different languages come from? I love all the different languages, hearing them, learning some of them. Today, we're going to learn where all those different languages came from. We're going to talk about a crazy tower. And we're also going to talk about the fact that God is worthy of worship. Now, what does worship mean?
According to the Oxford English Dictionary, worship is a feeling or expression of reverence and adoration for a deity.
Okay, that guy looks strangely familiar.
We must be twin cousins?
I don't think it's that.
I don't see the resemblance.
Isaiah 40:28 says, "The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom." God is worthy of worship, our praise, our attention, our focus, because he is amazing. He is everything to us. So we're going to look into Genesis chapter 11, the very first book of the Bible, and chapter 11 verses 1 through 9, and chapter 12 verses 1 through 4. We're going to compare two different people, a group of people in the land of Shinar, and a man named Abraham, and what they did with worship. So Genesis chapter 11, starting in verse 1. "Now the whole earth used the same language and the same words. It came about as they journeyed east that they found a plain in the land of Shinar and settled there. They said to one another, 'Come, let us make bricks and burn them thoroughly.' And they used bricks for stone and they used tar for mortar. And they said, 'Come, let us build for ourselves a city and a tower whose top will reach into heaven. and let us make for ourselves a name. Otherwise, we will be scattered abroad over the face of the earth. Then the Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the sons of men had built. And the Lord said, Behold, they are one people, and they have all the same language. And this is what they began to do. And now nothing which they purpose to do will be impossible for them. So come, let us go down there and confuse their language, so they will not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad over the face of the whole earth, and they stopped building the city. Therefore, its name was called Babel, because there the Lord confused the language for the whole earth, and from there the Lord scattered them abroad for the face of the earth. So this group of people was getting together, and they were thinking that they were amazing. They were speaking in all the same language at that time. And they started purposing their heart, we're gonna build a big city. We're gonna make ourselves famous. We're gonna make a name for ourselves because we are so awesome. In fact, we could build a tower that reaches to heaven. Now, why in the world would that be a crazy thing? Why would God not like that? Because they thought that they were so amazing, they didn't need God. They thought they were so awesome that we are gonna make ourselves famous. We're gonna build a tower that reaches heaven because we don't need God. We're gonna worship and adore ourselves. So God came down and confused their languages. He gave them different languages so they couldn't all communicate together with this terrible plan to try to make themselves great and to build a tower to heaven. And that caused them to have to scatter. And they had to find the people that understood them and spoke their language, and they began to spread out. Now we're going to turn right to the next chapter, chapter 12, verse 1. And we're going to compare the people of Shinar that were building this tower, and we are going to compare them with Abram. Now the Lord said to Abram, now if you know the story, later God changes his name to Abraham, father of many nations. Go forth from your country and from your relatives and your father's house to the land that I will show you. And I, wait a minute, who's talking here? God. Watch what God says to Abram. I will make you a great nation, and I will bless you, and I will make your name great. And so you shall be a blessing, and I will bless those who bless you, and the ones who curse you, I will curse. And in you, all the families of the earth will be blessed. Wow, do you see the difference there? The people of Shinar who are building this tower, they're trying to make themselves great. They're trying to, in essence, worship themselves because they think they're amazing. They don't need God, they think, and they're going to try to build a tower to heaven. But then we see Abram, who the Bible says God called him a friend of God. Abram was a man that worshiped God. He put God first, he loved him, and he wanted to do what God wanted him to do with his life. And because he was a man who worshiped God, put God first, God came to him and said, I'm gonna make you great. I'm gonna bless you. And God gave him a promise that all people would be blessed through Abraham. Because of his faith, God gave him a promise that one day through his family line, God was gonna send a savior. Jesus was gonna come through the line, the family line of Abraham. And through Jesus, everyone would be blessed if we put our faith in him and worship God. Jesus is amazing. He is worthy of worship because he is the creator of everything. He is everlasting, and he loves us so much that he came to give his life for us, to take care of the sin problem that every human being has. The sin problem that causes people to try to worship other things, to try to worship money and fame and themselves and anything else other than God. But Jesus loved us so much that he came and he died for us. He rose again from the dead, and he is worthy of worship. So today, if you say, you know what, Pastor John, I have never put my faith in Jesus, would you pray this with me? Say, dear Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. I believe you rose again from the dead. And I ask you today to come into my heart. Come live in me. Take away my sin. And I want to live the rest of my life for you. Thank you for saving me. And I choose this day to worship you all the rest of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God is worthy of worship. Put him first in your life, and he will do amazing things in you and through you.
Hello, and welcome to Stinky Situations. Playing today will be Stephen, Claire, Kevin, Jenna, and you. We are going to put each of our four contestants in a stinky situation, and you are going to guess what each contestant will choose to do. Sound complicated?
Mm-hmm.
You'll catch on. Let's start with Claire.
Oh, yay.
You are babysitting a cute, cuddly little baby. After the baby falls asleep, you go in and check on him, and guess what? He made a stinky. That's right, number two. Now, here are your choices. You can take responsibility, wake the baby up, and change his diaper. Or you can sneak out and pretend that you never noticed. All right, here's the part where you get to play. Stand up if you think Claire will change the baby's diaper. Sit down if you think she'll pretend she never noticed. So what's it gonna be, Claire? Take responsibility or pretend you didn't notice? Okay, let's see what Claire chose. So you chose to be sneaky about it, huh? Not cool, Claire, but at least you're honest. Okay, everybody take a seat. It's time for round two. All right, Kevin, it's your turn. Here's your stinky situation. You are on a road trip with your parents and your sister. Your dad asks where you want to go eat. You say Mega Awesome Burger. Your sister says Victoria's Vegan Tofu Bar. Gross! Your parents decide to go with your sister's pick. She got to choose last time. That's totally not fair! Now let's look at your choices. You could throw a raging fit. Or you could be thankful. Think about it, Kev. Some people in this world didn't get to eat at all today. Maybe you could be thankful for what you get. Time for you to play. What will Kevin choose? If you think he'll throw a major fit, stand up. But if you think he'll choose to be thankful, have a seat. So what's it gonna be, Kevin? Nice choice, Kevin. Okay, everybody sit down because it's time for round three. Our next contestant is Stephen. What's up, Stephen? Here is your stinky situation. You're being attacked by ninjas. They have come to dishonor your family and kick you in the face. What do you do? Well, I guess we lost Stephen. That's it for round three. Let's move on to round four. Jenna, you have to move to a new state. New town, new house, new school, new friends, new everything. But you liked your old school, your old house, and your old friends.
Huh?
You know what I mean. Your old friends. Not your old friends, your old friends. That's your stinky situation, and here are your choices. You could pray for God's help and try really hard to make some new friends. Or you could mope around thinking about how hurt and alone and how angry you are. So what do you think Jenna will do? Stand up if you think she'll get out there and make some new friends. Sit down if you think she's just going to mope around. Nice choice, Jenna. Get out there and make some new friends. That concludes this episode of Stinky Situations. Here's wishing you wisdom in the stinky situations life throws at you.
Now I want to challenge you to do some fun stuff this week. Try to build a tower as high as you can, whether you have blocks or cardboard boxes. See how big of a tower you can build, and then you can tear it down. But remember that we don't want to worship ourselves. We don't want to worship things or money. We want to put God first in our life and worship Him. So why don't you go ahead as well and get a piece of paper this week, and you can look at Genesis chapter 11 and chapter 12, the people in Shinar building this tower, and then compare that with Abraham and the blessing that God gives to him and how God wants to make him famous because he chose to worship God. And then you can also write a list of things. What are some things that people tend to worship or put first in their life? And then write a list of the things that you are thankful about God. Some things about God that you can give Him praise and worship. That you say, God, thank you that you are loving. Thank you for sending Jesus. Thank you that you have given me grace and salvation. Thank you for the things that you have blessed me with in my life. Thank you for health. Thank you. And you can make a list of all the different things in your life and give God worship. Give Him praise. Give Him honor for how good He is and for how amazing He has been in your life.
Wow, Victory Kids, that was such an incredible message. God truly is worthy of our worship. He's the only one who is. So when we worship Him, we've got to give Him 1,000,000,000,000,000% of our efforts, because He is the one who's worthy of it. To end our service today, I'm going to have everyone hold out their hands like this and get ready to receive a blessing that I'm going to speak over you. Let's go. May you remember this week that God is worthy of your praise and worship, and may you remember that obeying God is an important way to worship Him. All right, Victory Kids, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you all have an incredible week, and remember, God is worthy of worship. Say bye, friends!
Goodbye.
We're the Victory Kids.
Yeah, we're growing in Jesus. Read the word every day cause we need it. Making friends one kid at a time, even the ones in the back of the line.
We're the Victory Kids.
Serving others with our gifts and talents. Put others first, yeah, that's the challenge. Reaching the world, we're making disciples.
It's nice right here. We're the Victory Kids.